Let's talk about money in retirement. I was retired, and I'm going to tell you about it. One of the reasons that you don't hear these type of stories is the time that most people retire, they're usually old. There's an expectation that they should be retired, that they should have plenty of free time. I was retired at a relatively young age. I believe it was 43. And let me explain to you how it happened. I wrote my first book, Making Money A to Z with Self-Storage Unit Auctions. The first year, I had really good sales of $62,000. The second year, I had great sales of $90,000. The third year, I did over $1 million. When this happened, I didn't have any debt. I didn't have a car payment. I was living on, quote, a self-imposed fixed income. And I just upped it up a little bit and I continued on. Monthly mortgage was paid. Like I said, I just had really little bills. When your house is paid for or you have a low housing payment or your car is paid for, it doesn't take a lot of money to live and to live well. So this is where I started to experiment. This is where I had all of this free time to do these things, try these experiments, play this. I traveled a little bit, but travel at that time was not really my thing. Today, we're hearing this thing called FIRE, Financial Independence Retire Early. I have a problem with the FIRE movement, and I'm going to explain it to you in a methodology that I think will make sense. Going back to my example of where I was truly and legitimately retired, I had to do nothing and money came in. A lot of money came in. The FIRE movement is very debatable because you retire at 35. You have your portfolio, you're withdrawing 4%. What are you gonna do if someone gets cancer? Now bring this up, not to be all dark and lugubrious. There's a guy, and I talked about him before. He's 84 years old, and he's driving the truck to pay for his wife's medical bills. He retired, paid off his house, had money put away, had a pension, one illness, totally rearranged their financial life. What I want to submit to you is let go of this fantasy of saving up enough money where you could do what you want. Because as a person who was legitimately retired, there's a few things that are going to happen. Now, I got sick and almost died. Fortunately, my issues were very simple. I did not have massive medical bills or nothing like that. It was something that I could pay for really quickly. I couldn't work for 2 months. And this was during the time that I had financial independence. And I should explain this. When I wrote my first book, I had, due to hard work and savings, had enough money in the bank to easily live 2 years. And I gave myself permission to chase a dream from actually working for that dream. I've always been in a position that if something happened, that generally I'd be fine. So during this time, I couldn't work. That was my main focus, not where I'm gonna live, not if I have money for medicine. My main focus was getting better. From working in the hospital, I have seen what one illness, not even cancer, just one will do to a family's financial plan. So if you go ahead and you, quote, retire early on a fixed income and something happens, oh, wait a minute. Because you have assets, you can't get Social Security, you can't get Medicaid, because you would have to get rid of all that to get the help that you may need eventually or exhaust that. Just another point of contention. There is a problem with people, quote, retiring early. The chances of you outliving your money are very great. We are experiencing many retirees who are in their 70s, their 80s, and their 90s, and they're starting to outlive their money. So if you retire at 25, 35, and once again, that's dubious, because you can't stop working. You can't. And this is one of the bad things about passive income. I had true passive income that regardless of what I did or didn't do, the money came in. Passive income will at some point be disturbed. Currently, we're in the end of a record bull market. You know when this happened before? Shortly before the book, The Millionaire Next Door, came out. It was at the end of a record bull market. Put your money in stocks, do this, live cheap. Same thing all over again. What happened? A lot of people were financially executed. Their portfolios dropped 30, 40, 50, 60, and 70%, depending upon how it was arranged. My argument is you need active income the rest of your life. Going back to the medical things, if you're a Facebook friend of mine, I have an article about genetic coding. They're actually able to go in and design babies now. Let's say you're 55, you retired at 25, so, you know, that's 30 years. Then they come out with this new technology. Let's say you have a heart problem, and this new technology is $350K to get you a new heart, where they take your cells and grow you a new heart and insert it, and that means your body doesn't reject your own tissue. You think that stuff's gonna be cheap? There are many people who are living on a fixed income, and a greater percentage of their income goes towards their medication than their rent or their mortgage, if they have one. The older you become, your priorities of where your money shifts is very interesting. You may not have a new car, you may not have a mortgage, but you will have medical expenses. Someone told me recently that more than 52% of Americans were on some type of prescription medication. I didn't believe it. I'm not on anything. I'm not on blood pressure medicine. I'm on nothing. And I was just thinking, you gotta be kidding me, and looked it up and it was true. What's gonna happen from a medical standpoint is gonna be very fascinating. It's gonna be groundbreaking. It's gonna be earth-shattering, and you're not gonna be able to afford it if you stop working. My opinion, once again, you need active income and you need to work for as long as you can. Now, in my course, you know, where we talk about financial independence, your first priority is to get where many of the FIRE people are, to a point where they get to control their time. They have money coming in, they don't have to work a set schedule, but they still have to work. That's the first step. The second step is to get to where you're making 10 to 20 times more money than the average income, because at that point you're classified as rich. Then this sets the stage for you to become wealthy. One of the greatest things I see is people don't want to be responsible for anything. But mark my words, it is very hard for you to become financially independent, rich, or wealthy without responsibilities, unless you're the offspring or the wife or husband of someone who's shouldering those responsibilities. This abdication of, hey, I just want to do me. I just want to have all this free time to do whatever I want to do. It's going to bite a lot of people in the ass. I believe, and this is a person who lives off of 10% of their income, that you should work as long as you can. Doesn't have to be a job, but it needs to be something that you like to do that makes money. And this whole notion of, oh yeah, let's go back to my retirement. You know, one of the weirdest things that I found out, even though I was retired and I had all of this freedom and I could do what I want, most of the people that I knew couldn't. They were still on that Friday, Saturday, Sunday schedule. Most of the events were Friday, Saturday, Sunday. You will find yourself in a situation where you have great personal freedom, and if you have a mate, that's cool, but you will find out that most folks can't do it. Even folks who make a lot of money because they have responsibility, they just can't take off when they want to. Just kind of giving you an inside look on this thing, because retiring with nothing to do except just wake up and do something is one of the fastest ways to end your life. In this neighborhood I live, and I've been here about 11 years, one of the things that I have seen over and over and over again is people that have retired pick up a second job, an odd job, teach, they do something, because they know if they sat at home just hanging out that they would die. You ever notice how when a long couple that's been married a really long time, first one dies, within months or a year, the second one goes. They don't have any reason to live. They don't have anyone that they could be around. They don't have, it's crazy how often that happens. It's amazing. What we're gonna talk about is active income. We're not gonna talk about, quote, playing with fire, because where most of them end up, which is financial independence, is the ability to have money coming in without working a regular job or set hours. That to me is just stage one. Stage two is getting rich, and stage three is becoming wealthy. And some of them are kind of doing that, but I just think that it is crazy to come out of the job force, have this stack of money that's predicated on a entity, the stock market, which is heavily emotionally manipulated. Because let's say you do everything right. Let's say you hit all your numbers. Then a recession happens and your portfolio loses 30-40%. But you've been out of the workforce for 4 or 5 years. You know, and this is something else too. Once you come out the workforce X amount of years, it's very hard to get back in. I would rather have you save money, manage money, because like I said, the FIRE movement has money management. They got that down pat. Spending, they got that down pat, but they don't go far enough. And I'm just telling you, as a person who has experienced legitimate retirement, you know, cracked up to what you may think it is, because you're in a position where you don't know what it looks like. You don't know what it tastes like. It's just like, wow, this thing over here is just amazing. I can't wait to get there. Trust me, it's not going to be what you think it is. And I have been living this lifestyle. I have older videos where I talked about, I save 50% of my income. And it's, I think, dubious, because the way that they present it, I've been living like that for many years. But I don't consider myself retired. The only time that I was truly retired was when my book was bumping and I was just chilling at home. Two years, and well, I actually diverted my time and attention to other things. You're gonna live a long time. I hope you live a long time. You're gonna look good. I hope you look good. And you're gonna need some money. You're gonna need some money. This whole notion of what I call pathologically cheap, I just don't think it's the way to go. Personal opinion. Because if I'm sitting on a portfolio of $3 to $10 million, there's no way that I'm staying in a $60 per night hotel room. There's no way that I am taking some cheap travel. What I bring to you is have the proper money management systems in place. Do that. But also live. One of the things that we're going to discuss in my new school is what I call the 50% solution or 10% solution. Like I said, I live on 10% of my income, but it's a very high income. So my 10% will still be balling to most people. I want you to live like that. I don't want you to live like a beggar. I don't want you to live all cheap. I want you dressing out of goodwill. I want you to have a choice to live your life the way you want to. And once again, I have seen what happens to pathologically cheap people. It becomes a habit, and the habit becomes a lifestyle. You can't even enjoy the money because you're so cheap. Just some thoughts. So for those of you who want to learn how to make more money, because that's one of the core tenets, go below, get enrolled into the basic financial education program. It's $75 right now, one-time payment, or $100 for payments of $25. When I do the next thing, which will be another thing, whatever I charge for that, I will take off whatever you pay for the first course. So, because it's going to contain the same information. Plus, I'm going to add, just to be clear, I'm going to do tier one, which is the basic financial education. Then I'm going to do tier two, then tier three. Tier three, which will be a monthly fee, and tier four. You will not have to pay for the same information you already have. Because that way, when people come after you, they can go like, hey, I can do tier one, I can do tier two, or I can do tier three, or I can do tier four. And it'll already be set up. Because like I said, I've learned from setting up these courses how to do this. So once again, that is below. And just think about it. Would you rather live off of 10% of 10 million or 4% of a million? Put your comments, put your answers in the comment section. I really want to know, because one of my Facebook friends actually posted this, and I thought it was just crazy that people are so drunk on credit, and I should say American people, that folks would rather have a high credit score of 850 than $600,000 in cash. You could tank my credit for 600K. 600K, I get that back so quick. 600K cash money, that is money within 5 to 10 years you could turn to millions, where you could pay cash for everything, like a house. But people are so drunk on that credit score, it's ridiculous. Anywho, I'll see you guys in the next video.
We'll be right back.